Lillian has had a very trying time since she walked out of that relationship. She is distressed. She has done whatever she has tried to do to stop it. She has been to court. That has not stopped Dr. Alfred Latour. She has gone to the police. That has not stopped Governor Mutua. She is now speaking out because she cannot hold back anymore.
On repeated occasions, I've seen Alfred say that we are still friends and the separation has been amicable. These are Mr. Mutua's usual theatrics and lies, as Alfred and I have not spoken since August 2021. On September 8, 2021, Mr. Mutua, accompanied by his police bodyguard, Martin Zinge, arrived at my apartment and took away a car that was fully registered in my name with a spare key that he had illegally obtained. Mr. Mutua fraudulently transferred the ownership of the car in the lock into his name and thereafter sold the vehicle to a third party. I filed a case which is pending in court, so I'll not comment further on this. I wish to rather state that the purchaser should be on notice that I maintain ownership to the vehicle. I called for a criminal investigation into this serious criminal offence by Alfred Mutua. Along the same fraudulent conducts, Mr. Mutua recently and illegally transferred my shares in the Dash Enterprises, the hotel company, to his sister Anne Bandy Mutua. Again, a clear act of fraud. At no point did I execute a transfer of my shares or otherwise transfer my 1,800 shares, that is 45% shareholding the company to him, let alone his sister. Both documents have been lodged at the company registries together, effectively defrauding me of 90% of my shareholding in Dash Enterprises, a company I founded in 2014, indeed after my own high school nickname. I was called Raptin Dash in school, so you can ask anybody I went to school with. The two documents, which bear a stamp dated 12th and 13th August 2021, bear what resembles my signature, but not in original form. And clearly the signatures have been electronically superimposed. The transactions by Mr. Mutua are clear and obvious frauds, which he has committed in false and mistaken belief that he's above the law and will not be held to account for his criminal acts against me. I reported this serious crime to Kilimani Police Station under OB number 48/15/09/2021. Mr. Mutua is reacting to our separation. Was indicated that I wanted to move on with my life, he thought otherwise. At a meeting at Windsor Golf and Country Club on September 22nd, in the company of our two mutual friends, and of the two criminal incidents, I requested Alfred Mutua for a mature and amicable separation, and reminded him that after all, we were not married. I said we were not legally married, we were long-term partners.